Remediating Excel Documents. Content developed by New Edition Consulting.
Welcome. Thank you for joining this discussion on remediating Excel documents for accessibility. Before we begin, you will want to familiarize yourself with the built-in accessibility checker. This tool is the easiest and fastest way to give you an overview of possible problems in your document. Many of the items that you will be checking for can be identified using this built-in checker. The accessibility checker lists exactly where each issue occurs and when each line item is selected. You have the option to have that error explained. To access the accessibility checker, navigate to the Review tab and then select the accessibility checker. The accessibility checker will populate on the right-hand side of the screen. An important thing to note about the accessibility checker is sometimes generate false positives. So in this example, I've activated the accessibility checker, but it's telling me that there are no issues within this document. However, I know that there are some issues, and if I go in and do some manual checks, I can fix those problems and create a more accessible document. In addition to using the accessibility checker, you also want to make sure that you set your document's properties. So to do that, navigate to the File, Info, and go over to Document Properties where the title field is located. In the title field, you need to enter a descriptive title name for this document. So for this one, I'll enter Type of Pet. And I'll navigate back to the document and continue working. Once you confirm that the document's properties have been properly identified, make sure that any sections within the document are identified using the preset style tools that are available under the Home tab. So if you navigate back to Home, under Styles, there are a number of different styles you can select, and the heading levels are located here. You have the option of selecting a heading level 1 through a heading level 4. Traditionally, your document should only have one heading level 1, and that would be the document's title. So for this document, I'm going to navigate to the cell that contains my title, and that's Types of Pets by State. And to confirm whether or not there is a proper heading identified, I'll navigate to the Style pane. And it looks like there is no heading identified, so I'm going to go ahead and assign the heading level 1 to my title. In addition to confirming heading levels, find any hyperlinks within the document and make sure that the linked text is clear, it's unique, and it's descriptive. Generic phrases like more or click here should be avoided because users of assistive technology rely on unique and descriptive link text to communicate the destination and the purpose of that link. So it looks like in this document there is a hyperlinked URL. So to confirm that that is set up properly, I'm going to navigate to the hyperlinked text, right click, and this is where I can see if that is in fact hyperlinked, and if I want to, I can edit that hyperlinked text. So in the hyperlink window, you can edit the text that is displayed as well as the address. So for this example, I've got this URL taking me to an Animal Planet website, and the text I've displayed is unique and descriptive to that particular location. Properly structured tables are essential for users of assistive technology to navigate throughout a table, identify column headers, such as these, as well as the relationships between the data cells and those headers. There are a few steps to follow when confirming that your table is structured properly. So before I begin to structure my table, I want to make sure that I've identified all of the information present. So I know that my name, my state, and the type of pet is going to be my table header. And the subsequent data cells are the related information. So properly structuring a table in Excel means using the insert table function. And that insert table function is what will communicate to users of assistive technology that all of that information in the table is related. So it looks like right now, visually, this information might be set up as a table because each of these cells is blocked out using a black outline. But to confirm that this is actually a properly structured table, I'm going to navigate to the Home tab and then Find and Select. And once I've selected Find and Select, The go to button will give me an idea of any of the tables that are in this document. So I know now that this is not a properly structured table, that the insert table function wasn't used. Otherwise, it would be selectable here. So I'm going to navigate back to the table and make sure that I do use that insert table function. So before I do that, I want to clear the styles that have been already put in. So to do that, I'm going to go to the font and then all borders option and select no borders. So removing those grids will take away the idea that this is a structured table when in reality it is not. So to make this a properly structured table, I'm going to highlight all of the content that I want included in the table. I'm going to navigate to the Insert tab and select Table. Once I've selected Table, I need to make sure that I select the My Table Has Headers button. And this is important because this is what will allow assistive technologies to relate the data cells to those header cells. I'm going to select OK. Once you've used the Insert Table function to make sure that your table is structured properly, just know that by default, there will be a filter that populates. It is up to you whether you want to keep that filter or not. If you highlight the table that you're working in and you navigate through the Design tab, there is a filter button that allows you to choose whether or not you want those filters present. Now that I confirm that my table is structured properly, as I resize the cells in my table, I notice that my URL, while it is a descriptive link, it is not immediately following the preceding information. So users might not know that they need to navigate all the way over to cell 10F. So to correctly format my URL and the preceding information, I'm going to move that so that it follows the information directly preceding it. So now a user will know to navigate them more information about household pets, and directly following that is the URL that they can access that information at. So the final thing that we will discuss today is color contrast. When using color, make sure that you are confirming that the difference between the foreground color and the background color has a minimum color contrast of 4.5 to 1. That difference between the foreground and the background is what we call color contrast. So as an example, I'm going to navigate to the font color selection, and I'm going to choose the preset standard red. And to confirm that this has a proper color contrast of 4.5 to 1, I'm going to use my color contrast tool. The color contrast tool that I'm using has been downloaded from the internet. There are a number of free tools that you can access as well. So I'm going to select the background color, and I'm going to select the foreground color. My color contrast analyzer tool will automatically generate a contrast ratio, and I can see that this contrast ratio is 4 to 1. So it falls short of the 4.5 to 1 requirement. So to fix that, I'm going to navigate back up to the font color and choose a darker colored text. So a fun fact is that anytime you need to use red text, just remember that the standard red does not meet the 4.5 to 1 color contrast ratio, but the dark red does. Thank you again for joining this basic overview on remediating Excel documents for accessibility. For more accessibility resources, visit the NCRTM Accessibility Resources page.
For additional help, feel free to contact the NCRTM support team and contact them at ncrtm@newadditions.net.